Welcome to this Python syntax crash course. In the next 5 minutes, I'll guide you through all the essential parts of Python, from basic syntax to more advanced features. Let's dive in. 1. Printing output. In Python, to print output to the screen, use the print function. For example, if you want to print the text, "Hello, world," simply use the print function and pass the text inside it. This will print the text exactly as it appears inside the quotes. 2. Variables and data types. Variables are used to store data. Python automatically determines the type of data. For example, you can assign a string to a variable like name equals John, an integer like age equals 25, a float like height equal 5.9, and a boolean like is_student equals true. You don't need to specify a data type because Python figures it out for you. 3. Getting user input. To get user input, use the input function. Remember, it returns data as a string by default. For instance, if you ask for the user's age, you can use age equals input, enter your age. However, if you need to convert the input into an integer or float, you'll need to use int or float. Functions like age equals int, input enter your age. 4. Conditional statements. Python uses if, elif, and else to make decisions based on conditions. For example, you might check if someone is an adult with if age greater than or equal to 18, or check if they are a teenager with elif age greater than or equal to 13. You can also use else for other cases. Notice how Python uses indentation instead of curly braces to define blocks of code. 5. Loops. Loops allow us to repeat code multiple times. Python has two main types, for loops and while loops. A for loop can be used to iterate through a sequence of numbers. For example, you can print numbers from 0 to 4 with for I in range 5. A while loop keeps running as long as a certain condition is true. For instance, you could use while count 5 to print numbers until count reaches 5. 6. Functions. Functions are reusable blocks of code that perform a specific task. You define them with a def keyword followed by the function name. For example, to create a function greet that prints a greeting, you define it with def greet name and call it using greet Alice. This way, you can reuse the code without having to rewrite it each time. 7. Lists. Lists are ordered collections that can store multiple values. For example, you can create a list of fruits like fruits equals apple, banana, cherry. You can access items in a list by their index, starting from 0. For example, fruits 0 will give you apple. You can also loop through a list to perform actions with each item, like for fruit in fruits, to print each fruit in the list. 8. Dictionaries. Dictionaries are key value pairs. They store data in an unordered way, but you can access it by keys. For example, you could define a dictionary like person equals name, John, age, 25, height, 5.9. You can access values by using the corresponding key, like person name, which will give you John. 9. Comments. Comments are used to explain your code, making it easier to understand. Single-line comments start with a hashtag symbol. For multi-line comments, you can use triple quotes. Comments are ignored by Python when the code runs, so they don't affect your program. 10. Indentation. Indentation is crucial in Python. Python uses indentation to define blocks of code instead of curly braces like other programming languages. Typically, you use 4 spaces for each level of indentation. If your indentation is incorrect, Python will raise an error. 11. Error handling. To handle errors in Python, you can use try and accept blocks. If an error occurs within the try block, Python will jump to the accept block and execute the code there. For example, if you try to divide by 0, you can catch the error using accept 0 division error and print an error message without crashing your program. That covers the essential Python syntax. You've learned how to print, use variables, get input, make decisions, repeat code, define functions, work with lists and dictionaries, add comments, manage indentation, and handle errors. Now, practice these concepts and start building your own Python projects. Want to dive deeper? Subscribe and keep practicing. I'll see you in the next lesson.